boy life as if he were one, buying enormous mansions and rare supercars and traveling the world in ultimate luxury. Even his custom-designed trailer is worth more than a normal person's house. So how does Dom Toretto spend all of his hard-earned cash? Let's find out. We're not going to spend any time beating around the bush. Here's the kicker. Vin Diesel is worth a staggering $200 million. That's more than Bruce Willis, Jim Carrey, and Morgan Freeman, and three times more than Jake Gyllenhaal. As you can see, Vin is no slouch, and he's worked darn hard for it, too. Before his career really took off, Vin was working the door as a bouncer for a nightclub. Fast forward to today, and he's coming off a salary of close to $54.5 million in 2019 alone. But even $200 million could be chump change compared to what he could be worth very soon. Before you know it, Vin Diesel could move into billionaire territory. But we'll get into that a little later. For now, let's jumpstart things by talking a little bit about Vin's spending habits, shall we? What's the first thing you would do if you had $8 million in your bank account? Well, if you're Vin Diesel, a man infamous for fast cars, then you buy a car, of course. Or you buy about 20. But unlike most celebrities who splurge on the newest, shiniest, fastest, and most expensive rides to up their street cred, Vin goes for the classics. Well, most of the time.
Nothing sadder than locking a beast in a cage.
So what exactly is sitting in his garage? For starters, you've got the 1974 Plymouth Barracuda. 74 was actually the last year that this car was made, so he's pretty lucky to own one, considering they've been out of production for so long. Then we've got one of the most iconic cars in U.S. history. Any guesses? Yep, the 1969 Dodge Charger Daytona. There were only 503 of these bad boys ever produced. But if anyone deserves one, it's Dom Toretto himself. Speaking of Toretto, does anybody who's seen the Fast and the Furious films recognize this set of wheels? Yup, that's the real one featured in the movies, and Vin Diesel actually owned it himself for a while. The regular release model sported a 5.7-liter V8 engine that churned out 245 horsepower, but rumors have been swirling around that Vin's model had over 1,500. You don't need to know much about cars to know that 1,500 is way more than 245. But by far, his most exotic and powerful car is the 2014 Lycan Hypersport. This $3.4 million beast is built by W Motors, and only seven of them were ever produced, making it one of the rarest cars that money can buy. Noticing a certain sparkle to the headlights? That's because they're embedded with diamonds and jewels. With an acceleration time of 2.8 seconds for 0 to 60, and a top speed of 245 miles an hour, it really is one of the fastest cars in the world, and the fastest in his garage. Vin's also got three Japanese cars, a 1994 Toyota Supra, a 1993 Mazda RX-7, and a 2009 Subaru Impreza WRX STI. And if that wasn't enough, he was given something extra special for his 52nd birthday. His colleagues from the Fast and the Furious franchise surprised him with what is easily one of the most impressive muscle cars ever produced, a 1970 Dodge Charger Tantrum.
So on behalf of your Fast family...
This beast was also heavily modified, injected with a boat engine. Yes, a boat engine. A 9-liter twin-turbo V8 engine from Mercury Marine Racing. While he didn't buy it with his own cash, per se, it certainly adds to his overall value.
What?
All right, enough about cars. Time for the big-ticket items, the properties. First up, we're heading to the Hollywood Hills. Back in 2016, Vin listed his place for sale for around $1.4 million. It's actually a rather modest two-bedroom, three-bathroom house, but don't worry, it's not his only pad. He bought this place 16 years earlier, back in 2000, for just $562,500. That's one hefty markup. As you can see, it's not overly flashy, especially for a place in the Hollywood Hills. Over in Atlanta, however, it's another story. This 11,000-square-foot monstrosity has a list of features and amenities long enough to make anyone jealous. All right, are you ready for this? A 12-person dining room. A three-car garage, a bar, seven bedrooms, nine bathrooms, an elevator, four patios, a full gym, obviously, an entire guest house with a kitchen, a cinema room, a pool, a spa, a rooftop deck, and a wine cellar. Not too shabby. On top of that, he's also apparently got a pad hidden up in Beverly Hills that was purchased for $2.25 million. And his neighbors are pretty famous in their own right. They're none other than Kate Upton and Justin Verlander. Now, not only does our main man Vin Diesel buy himself classic cars and fancy houses, but as we all know, he's deeply intertwined within the movie industry. It's not just spinning around corners and jumping midair through explosions on the big screen, though, Finn's actually heavily involved behind the scenes, too. He is the mastermind behind his very own production company, One Race Films, which he founded way back in 1995. His company purchased the XXX franchise, and while we don't know exactly how much Revolution Productions sold it to him for, we know it wasn't cheap by any means. One Race Films also produces video games and houses a record label, but as the name suggests, film is the primary focus. So Vin constantly reinvests his cash into the company in order to make it grow. And trust us, it's growing, largely because of one particular franchise under its belt. Any guesses? That's right, it's the Fast and the Furious. Technically Vin's company, and therefore Vin, have had major control over the infamous action series since the third installment, meaning that he also has a huge paycheck.
The milk guy's getting paid, the potato chip guy's getting paid, the beer guy's getting paid.
That reason alone is how Vin is on track to become a billionaire. Furious 7 and The Fate and the Furious, on their own, both made over $1 billion worldwide. And interestingly enough, the majority of the box office revenue came from overseas markets. All up, the Furious series has amassed well over $5. And who's the main man now behind all that cash? Vin Diesel. Of course, when you're smashing cars for fun and taking down bad guys non-stop, you need a vacation. Like any of us, Vin doesn't mind a quick getaway. But unlike most of us, he travels in absolute style. And when you're worth hundreds of millions of dollars, it's an easy thing to do. He's been seen all over the Canary Islands with his family, as well as over in Egypt, taking cliche touristy photos. But it's not all glitz and glam. Vin sometimes travels just to give back to the world. To bring in the 2020 New Year, the actor donated his time to the kids at the Maestro Cares Foundation Orphanage in the Dominican Republic, and shared his message of optimism with his 60-plus million Instagram followers. These trips would have easily set him back tens of thousands of dollars, especially considering that he often flies in private jets. And he doesn't just fly solo on those private jets. He shares the luxury with his nearest and dearest. Back in 2015, Diesel flew his son, Vincent Sinclair, through private skies to a Golden State Warriors game. His son was just 5 years old at the time. Pretty crazy, right? Some would even say that he'd be too young to appreciate it. What do you think? Anyway, that's just one of the countless times he's splurged on A-grade flying. Depending on the size of the plane, renting a private jet can cost well over $13,000 per hour. But that's barely a dent in Vin's overflowing bank balance. While he's also pictured here taking a few happy snaps in front of a Fast and Furious branded aircraft, unfortunately he doesn't own that one. It was simply the result of a promotion partnership with Etihad. From luxury in the sky to luxury on the ground, this next purchase is unlike anything we've seen before. It's an 1,100 square foot trailer, aka a pretty darn big motorhome, and it's decked out with more gizmos, gadgets, and accessories than you could ever imagine. Check it out. Spread across its two stories, it's got a high-tech media room and a kid's playroom equipped with soft cushioned floors. There's also a massive lounge area for guests lined with high-quality suede couches, another private lounge just for Vin, and an amazing kitchen that wouldn't look out of place in a normal house. Any guesses how much this thing is worth? We'll give you a hint. It's more than most people's houses. An excruciating $1.1 million. That just doesn't seem fair, does it? Not only does Vin travel as the rich travel and live as the rich live, but he knows how to party like a celebrity too. He's been seen living it up on boats, David Grutman's yacht specifically, and has also been seen partying into the night down in Miami alongside none other than Steve Aoki. And yes, Vin did get on stage, and yes, he did cake the audience. He's also hosted a crazy after party for Nina Dobrev's 30th birthday in early 2019. So as you can see, he's no stranger to a good time. It's not all about Vin though. Despite being a macho man known for dangerous stunts, he's a humble and sweet guy on the inside. Together with his wife Paloma, Vin's father to three kids, and he has spent millions of dollars on them over the years, giving them the best life possible as they've grown up. He's made it very clear, if he had to choose between his family and acting, he'd pick his children every single time. That's Hanaya Riley. You already know Vincent Sinclair, and this is his daughter Pauline. Unless you're a hardcore Vin Diesel fan, you might not have realized that he actually named Pauline after his dear friend and fallen Fast and Furious co-star, Paul Walker. Hanaya is already following in her father's footsteps, having made her on-screen debut alongside her dad in his new animated flick, Fast and Furious Spy Racers. And you can bet that he spoils her as well. Just take a look at this snap of the pair cruising around on a boat, living up.